Welcome to Muncie, Indiana, home of the Ball State Cardinals, and we're looking forward to this matchup, and certainly the fans are showing that they are as well. And boy, do we have a fun one ahead. Top 10 team, target on their back, going on their road and right into the snake pit. As we'll see, the number one team in the country, the Georgia Bulldogs, taking on a team from the MAC, the Ball State Cardinals. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Reese Davis, David Pollack, and Jesse Palmer with me. Guys, it's time to get it going. Georgia likely to kick it deep to get things started. The returner will field it and try to set up his offense in great field position. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. So the Ball State Cardinals offense will take the first swing of the game. And here comes their leader, Jesse. He just has a way of elevating everybody's play.
And he's a point guard, too. So good at distributing the football, finds the open guys, and he makes this offense go.
Makes it go, and just, you can trust him. Everything is available. You're not playing with one arm behind your back. You've got all guns blazing.
Well, there was really nowhere to go for the quarterback with that football. He's just trying to check it down to his running back, and the defense was there, and they made the play.
We'll see if they can dig one up. It goes forward this time on second down from the 18. The give to Davis. And the defense makes a big hit and knocks him down.
These are the ones in the stands where you get booed if it doesn't work. Why would the ball on second and long? You stink, OC. Or you get the big applause and you're like, yes, nice job. Keeping the manageable third down situation. Good call. So tough spot to be in second and long. Nice answer, nice run by the running back.
Back to pass, it's Kelly. He makes the connection. And they'll finally catch up to him, but not before a big chunk of yardage is picked up.
Awesome job there on third down by the QB, working through his progressions. He wanted to go downfield, but the defense took everything away. So his eyes come down, he finds the drag route underneath, makes a good throw, and his guy does the rest to pick up the first.
And the Cardinals racing to the line in the hurry up. Out of the shotgun, they go to the ground. He is going nowhere. Stop at the line of scrimmage.
And just a great job by the defense being stout. All right, that's your job. Be stout up front, stuff in the run play, make them get in more passing situations, but do not let them run the football. That's 101. Stop the run first.
Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. He'll try to pop the draw. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. That linebacker saw the express lane right to the ball carrier.
And a great job by the defensive line getting some push, making them use their resources on him. Linebacker comes free, able to make in the backfield for a tackle for a loss.
They line up, and it is a long way to the sticks from here. Throws to the wideout. Got him downfield. Open space at the 25. And they'll do more than move the chains. They'll move that thing more than 30 yards down the field before he's finally stopped.
Love the individual effort by the wide receiver after the catch, making people miss, showing you the speed. Now he set up his offense down in the red zone.
The Cardinals are moving quickly down the field. Give to the back. And he's a real nowhere man tackled in this no-gain land.
It's hard to run on a defense that comes off the ball like that and runs to the football like that. Good luck. No holes anywhere.
They got nothing on the last play. It's second and 10. Go to the ground. Got some room. Headed to the goal line. And he runs it in for the score. Cardinals.
The offense goes as he goes, so really no surprise in the opening drive. They keep feeding him the football. He shows you all of his ability on that TD.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And with the extra point, they get the first 7 of the game. They put together an 81-yard drive, and it was capped off with an impressive 18-yard touchdown run. The kickoff unit about to go to work. On the move from inside his 5. He was looking for more running room, but none to be found as he stopped at the 23. So Georgia's offense has the ball for the first time. As we take a look at our impact players for this game, David, what do you look for to make an impact from your leaders?
Your leaders not only have to lead the football team, but they got to step up and make plays on the field, keep everybody calm. These guys typically do a really good job of it.
Yeah, David, and they also generally set the tone for their respective football teams. Regardless of which side of the ball they play on, the teammates look towards them to step up in big games like this.
Now here on second down, see if they keep tossing it around. Pulls it and fires to the left. They get him on the ground at the 36 after a pickup of 5.
It's definitely the wide receiver's job to create space, right? So whether you're running a go or you're running a hitch like this right here, I got to find a way to push off legally or just create a little bit of space to get some positive yards.
They've got it at the 36. It's a 1st and 10. Use the play fake. Now to throw. Got it in the middle. It's Bell. He puts him in business across the 50 into the 46-yard line. It'll be 1st down.
That is a really good-looking throw. And you think about the expectation level now for quarterbacks at Georgia. Matthew Stafford was the #1 pick overall. Stetson Bennett won 2 national championships. Imagine the pressure on this guy. But when you see throws like that, he makes you believe that he can step up and lead this team to yet another natty.
The aerial assault continues. Complete downfield. They've got it inside the 30. They'll mark it at the 28. It's 1st down.
Yeah, I tell you what, these big body tight ends that can catch the football on the corner routes, it doesn't have to be a perfect throw. You know, usually you got littler guys, it's hard. You got to put the ball more on the money, but this big dude can just go up and get it. You just throw it near the sidelines, he'll do the rest.
He's got it on the right. Didn't pick up a lot there. Moved it forward just a few.
I love this defense's ability to fight off blocks and rally to the football. They do such a great job pursuing that wide receiver screen to only allow a minimal gain and no 1st down.
Line getting set on 2nd down. The run to the left. Blast his way ahead, but not much room. A pickup of 1 to the 24.
You know, runs like this oftentimes are like a boxer in a boxing match. Obviously, it's not a knockout punch, but these are body blows. As the game goes on, these small gains are going to turn into longer runs.
Both at the 24, a lot of confidence in their kicker from here, but they'd love to take it off of his foot and convert the 1st down. Unloads to the wideout. He's got an open man. They make the tackle, but he's got a fresh set of downs, and it's 1st and goal from the 7. And they just want to give this guy a chance to make a play on 3rd down, and more times than not, he is going to deliver.
And he's so good, so efficient, such a good route runner, got the speed, got the complete game, so you definitely want to highlight him, and especially on those downs that matter the most. If something's not open quick underneath, find him, he'll make those contested.
Touchdown, Bulldogs! And they'll put that scoreboard operator to work and put 6 on the board.
#6. And what a nice start for this offense. The throw game getting working, getting the touchdown pass, this quarterback getting a little bit of confidence, this passing game getting in a rhythm. Nice start for this offense.
On to attempt the try.
The kicker is on for the extra point.
Right in the middle.
The extra point
So it's a 77-yard touchdown drive, and they close the deal with the 7-yarder for the score. All tied up and just about set to kick it away. And he hauls it in, and everybody's on the edge of their seats. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. Ball State gets it back. The offense headed to the field. That last touchdown drive was surgical through the air, Jesse.
It sure was, and that's why this offense is so dangerous, David, because they can score in a hurry because of how efficient they are throwing the football.
And welcome to modern college football. That's what it is. Spread you out, find my playmakers, make quick decisions, and really put defenses in a difficult situation.
It's been punch, counterpunch throughout the early part of this game as we take a look at the first quarter stats. We've got a good one going here. I'm looking forward to keep those vibes rolling here in the second. Movement here from the tight end. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. They get him on the ground, but not before he gets enough for the first down.
Well, with the weapons this offense has, you knew it was just a matter of time in the run game before someone was going to break a long one. They'd just been running into a wall. They just couldn't seem to find their creases and get enough movement up front, but they finally got it there, picking up the first. Let's see what happens next.
Motion from the offense. Touch pass on the jet sweep. Past the first down marker and still running. Boy, did he look as if he was going to go. Gets it down to the 37.
And this receiver is so dangerous. There's so many different ways that he can hurt a defense. You got to throw it to him conventionally, but find creative ways to get him the football out in space and let him go to work.
And the Cardinals want to crank the tempo. Wide out in motion. Well, jet sweep pass. He's brought down, but he went backwards after that completion, not the way they had it drawn up.
Got to give the defense credit. Watching film, anticipating. They knew that this offense had this play in their back pocket. They knew about the speed of this wide receiver and different ways they were going to try to get him involved. Everybody on defense on the same page, playing together. I love it.
Quarterback flips it ahead quickly to the receiver. And this one will be stopped for no gain.
I like offenses being creative. I'm not sure if that was the best place to call that play. I think this offense needs to think about just doing things a little bit more by the book. They've got a lot of good playmakers. You don't have to reinvent the wheel this early in the game.
Third down conversions are a huge stat, and this one would be a doozy if they can pull it off. All kinds of room to throw that one in there. Touchdown, Ball State. What a grab and go for the score.
This guy is so dangerous because of his speed. He can take the top off the defense, and he did it right there on the post. Great arm talent, getting the throw out in front of him. It didn't matter how many DBs they had deep on that one. I don't think they could have stopped him.
PAT unit on the field. And the extra point is true, and they're on top by 7. So that scoring drive took only 6 plays. And the points come on a pass from 39 yards out. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. On the run from inside his own 5. Really disciplined job by coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. And Georgia ready to go back to work on offense. The running back has it. Knocked down after picking up 5 out to the 24.
It's going to be important this offensive line is able to get a little bit of push. Just got to give this guy an inch, a little crease, and he can make yards for it.
Halfway there on first down, it's second and five. Off bootleg, wants to throw it. Fires to the middle. A strike downfield. And he's knocked down immediately, but not before he moves the chains. It is great to have a tight end that can do it all and one that can get downfield and make a play.
And I like matching and mixing and matching up the play fake on play action with this tight end because it just gives him a little more time to work his route down the field. Nice play call there by the coordinator.
Going up top on first down. Oh, he's going to try to hit him deep. Catch in stride inside the 15. And the catch and run into the end zone. Touchdown, Georgia. Number six.
You know, quarterbacks and receivers, they develop confidence and chemistry as the game goes on. These two right now are definitely on the same page.
Lining up for the PAT. Hit that one with some aggression for the point after. Quick strike offense on that three-play scoring drive. And the score comes courtesy of the big play covering 61 yards on the touchdown pass. After that latest answer, tied things up, just about set to kick it away again. He'll bring it out. And he coughs it up inside the 20. Maybe some nerves on that return, but a fortunate bounce, and they'll retain possession. Ball State takes over the football, and the Cardinal offense headed out. These two defenses have had their heads spinning here in the first half, and now we might even see a little more scoring with this drive.
It's going back and forth. This is like two heavyweights just trading blows, David. What has this defense got to do to get a stop here?
I tell you what, man, when you're giving up points like this and you've got no momentum, you got to find somebody that can make a play to create some. And listen, if they're scoring anyways, let's be aggressive. Let's blitz more. Let's make sure we're making them feel discomfort in some way, shape, or form.
Leaves it with the back. Slams his way forward. He'll get three out to the 11.
I like feeding my guy. I like getting my running back touches, feeding the ball so he can break some of those big runs. But I'm also okay with these little ones. Set the tone, stay balanced.
Third and 10, still backed up inside their own 20. This drive hasn't really gotten started. Dropping back, it's Kelly. And he will be sacked at the six-yard line.
And how about the inside linebacker flying through there? You see those guys come up, and you see how fast they can come up and fit the run. But how about blitzing the quarterback, getting to the quarterback, getting the big sack?
The Cardinals decide to punt it away. Three and out, and not much choice but to get rid of the ball. So from his own end zone, the punt is away. He gets a block, and the punt team able to smack him to the ground. We're ready to get another look at this Bulldog offense. This could be a real turning point in the game. They scored a touchdown. They got a stop. And now a chance to break the tie.
Yeah, this offense has got it cooking, man. And how about the defense? Great job getting that stop, getting the football right back to the hot hand. Now this offense, Palmer, has a chance to take the lead.
You can see the offense, too. They understand the situation right now. They were jonesing on the sidelines to get another opportunity to run back on the field. They are ready to drive this ball and go score.
The offense showing motion from the tight end, trying to get a read on the D. Got it behind the line. It's Thomas. They've got it inside the 30. They'll mark it at the 28. It's first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. They'll throw it on first down. Wide open downfield. Defense makes a stop, but the chains move, and it's first and goal from the 8. This guy is just wearing them out. Another first down, already has a couple of touchdowns in the first half, David.
He has been a problem for this defense. And if I'm this offense, I'm going to continue to feature him. He's winning his matchups. I'm going to find him. It's just the first half, and he's already had himself a full game's worth of stats.
It's incomplete, and trust me, you will not see that very often from this guy. It's second down.
Man, that's one you expect him to make in his sleep, right? He's one of the better receivers in the entire country. He just dropped that one over the middle of the field.
Defense rose up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a second and long coming. They'll run it up the middle here, looking for a path to the end zone. He works his way all the way down to the three, and the defense is reeling.
And with the stuff there, Jesse, on second down, this little third to mid-range, you got two downs. What are you thinking here?
Maybe getting your quarterback out on the perimeter and giving him a run-pass option. See if you can get the defense in a bind.
They keep pushing forward down to the three, but now it's third and goal. And they can't quite hook up trying to make a completion in the back corner of the end zone.
Yeah, and third and short, they choose not to run, throw the football, and I think a lot of that has to do with they know they're in field goal range, they can take the 3 points on the board.
And on fourth down, they'll try to put three on the board. Neil boot one from the right hash. He ought to be able to navigate that angle from this distance. And he missed it. No good. And here in the second quarter, we remain all knotted up.
Well, everybody in the stadium thought that was an automatic three. Not so fast. Bad miss by the kicker.
Ball State gets it back. The offense headed to the field. Boy, three and out last time, Davey. They'd like to be more productive this time around.
Yeah, in the last drive, nothing really clicked. No rhythm, got off the field really, really quickly. They need to put something together here.
Yeah, David, bad execution on that last drive. So they got to take a collective breath and start playing like a unit on this drive.
That completion leaves us with second and medium. Back to pass, it's Kelly. And that's going to be incomplete. A lot of contact on the play, but no flags. It'll be third down. Trying to pick up a first down. In the gun, looking to throw on third down. Snagged in the middle, it's Robinson. Quick timeout from the offense to save precious seconds. He might have expected to see this DB up in his receiver's kitchen. Instead, nice little zone, and they pick up the first.
Man, offenses are getting so good, Reese, at seeing the holes in the zone, knowing you're in zone, knowing where to sit down, how to make it an easy pitch and catch for the quarterback, and that's what it was on third and short.
Second and 10 after the previous play. He's looking to throw. Right down the middle. Got his man downfield. Makes the stop at the 49, but not before he gets in plus territory, gets 15 and a first down. And the Cardinals come to the line with a fresh set of downs. He'll come out throwing on first down. Fires to the big fella. He's brought down quickly. Minimal gain there. Still a bit short of the first down. The offense calls timeout, and they won't have any more left this half. Just a quick rhythm throw there and really good use of the tight end.
Yeah, good use of the big fella. I mean, go through your progressions real quick. You can't find anything. Get the easy gain. Don't take a shot down the field all the time. Take those shots later, but take those easy, wide-open opportunities to get some positive chunks.
Well, they pick up the first against zone coverage. The biggest key there is the quarterback understanding that A, it's zone, but B, what kind of zone is it? Is it one high safety? Is it two high safeties? And then you know instinctively where your best throw, where your highest percentage completion is based on what type of zone coverage it's going to be.
Hit hard as he released the ball on that first down pass, and it never had a chance. On second second down, they'll try the field goal to get the points before halftime. And he's going to have to get into this football. This is a 53-yard attempt. The official says no good. Yellow hanky's flying, so let's see if the kicker's going to get another chance. This could turn out to be a huge penalty. Thought they were going to have to settle for three, and now the offense back on the field with a chance for more. It is true as he puts three up. And the field goal to end the half takes it to halftime. We've played two quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Guys, what a scene there in Muncie. What a fine performance we've seen. The passing game for both sides has been outstanding. On point, unrelenting. They've excelled in the short game, the intermediate game, and especially on the deep ball. All in all, a thrilling display of offensive firepower, and these defenses have a lot to discuss here at halftime. And with that, let's head back to the guys at Schumann Stadium.
The Cardinals will kick it away first, and we'll start the second half. He'll bring it back from inside his five. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. And Georgia ready to go back to work on offense. First play from scrimmage here in the second half, and they'll keep it on the ground. And he's brought down after a nice game.
You're down. Obviously, at the half, you had a conversation. We got to come out and put points on the board. And, Jesse, it looks like they're going to start with the ground game.
And I love this, David, too. Regardless of whether they're losing or they're winning, come out here and try to be the most physical unit here in the second half. Get this run game established.
Right back to the well. You'll take this every time. 5 yards on the first down play.
You see, they need more runs like that. It's been so few and far between. Defensively, they've been in position. They've been winning their one-on-one battles, getting off of blocks and rallying to the ball carrier. This defense has done a nice job slowing down the run game thus far.
Looking for space. It's Etienne. Good pickup there as he gets the first down, and they'll mark him at the 48.
And that is just an attitude run, running it right up the middle, right into the teeth of that defense.
Here they come, first and 10 from the 48. Use the play fake, now to throw. Fires it incomplete.
Quarterback there just trying to go to his primary target, and they're just not on the same page.
Let's see if they go back to the air after the incompletion. Second and 10 from the 48. Looking downfield, it's Beck. Quickly complete. They make the stop, trying to pick up just a little bit at a time to get to that first down marker. You can hand it to him, you can throw it to him. Either way, he's making his presence felt.
Those are your favorite plays, Reese, the him plays, right? They're finding ways to get him the ball because he can make plays, whether it's running or receiving out of the backfield. They're going to continue to highlight this guy.
He'll set up to throw. Fires into traffic, intercepted. Oh, he was hoping to make something out of that return, but they'll have it first down at the 39.
And that's just excellent cover. Man, cover one, nowhere to throw the football. Look at everybody playing man across the board, and you still got the safety in the middle of the field. Nobody open, and if I'm the QB man, I don't need to force it. I don't force it into tight windows if it's not there. He throws it, unfortunately, gets the interception. Bad decision by the QB there.
Ball State takes over the football, and the Cardinal offense headed out. They kicked a field goal on the last drive, Jesse. They've got the lead. Don't make a dumb mistake. but maintain your aggressive play calling.
Yeah, no doubt. And I think it's the play caller right now just taking a look at that script he's got in front of him and finding out, where are my playmakers? Who can we take advantage of on this defense to get a touchdown here?
Yeah, and just keep moving the ball down the field. Just execute a little bit better in the red zone. There's no need to panic. We're moving the football, and we got the lead.
From the gun, running back gets the give. And they make the tackle, but he has plenty for the first down. Looks as if we have an injury on that last play, and we'll take a break to check him out. They've got it first and 10 at the 50. They move the tight end all over. From the gun, leaves it on the inside with the back.
I know the passing game sells and the passing game is exciting, but it's not exciting to get 5 or 6 yards of pop on the ground, but it will be very successful.
Halfway there on first down, it's 2nd and 5. Back to throw, it's Kelly. And that's going to fall to the ground incomplete. That was a physical matchup there. Third down coming. We'll see if they go back to the air after the incompletion. It's 3rd and 5. Looking to throw on 3rd. Oh, they really could have used that catch there. Physical pass defense. It brings up a 4th down.
This is a point where you just got to be able to focus. And the critical down and distances in this game, like that 3rd down right there, when it's a good throw, you got to make the catch. You've got to be able to make that play.
And the Cardinals will try to pin them back with the punt. This will be the 2nd time they've had to kick it away. Wanted to make sure not to give them a chance for a return as it goes out of bounds. We're ready to get another look at this Bulldog offense. That last drive was promising for a while, but you just can't mess it up at the end with the pick, Jesse.
No, you got to be able to finish drives, especially in this game, if you're going to win. And David, they've got to be able to eliminate the mental mistakes.
Yeah, and I don't think you get conservative or play it safe. You can trust your guy. I think you put the ball right back in his hands and let him do his thing.
They'll snap this one from the 32. It's 1st down. They'll run it from the gun. A 7-yard pickup. It'll be 2nd and 3.
You want to talk about making it easy for an offensive coordinator. You pick up a bunch of yards on 1st down, make that 2nd down really, really manageable. That's a great job by the offense.
Good spot after that 7-yard pickup on 1st down. It's 2nd and 3. Give to the running back. The Bulldogs get it past the sticks.
And I don't care if I get it by 2, by 20, by 30, by 40. I just want to get the 1st down, understanding the situation, understanding where the sticks are. Doesn't have to be sexy, but I got to make sure I get to that stick, get to the 1st down mark.
Georgia ready to dial it up on another 1st down. Looking for a man. It's Beck. Gets it out quickly. And they'll get him down, but boy, did he put some dudes in the spin cycle. My goodness. So it's not just a strong running game. The Dogs can be dangerous with those weapons up top.
And I think when you've seen Georgia really dominate in college football over the last several years, it's because they've been more aggressive, more willing to throw the football early downs, trust their quarterback, not just the ground game.
They'll pick up 4, 2nd and 6 coming.
Small game, I know. But again, the defense knows he's going to run the football. He's willing to run the football, not just drop back and pass. Make him honor the run game. You got to do a lot of this.
Solid pickup of 4 on 1st down. It's 2nd and 6. To the ground with the back. Picks up the 1st down, still moving. And after a nice gain, the runner just scoots out of bounds.
And that's all you want, right? You want that first down. Understand the situation. Understand I got to get north and south, get a first down, get a new set of downs.
From the 22 on first and 10. They'll give it to the back. And he does a really nice job finding open space and making a good gain before the stop is made.
And a nice job by the running back finding space, getting downhill, making the good run. Great job finishing with his pads.
They can really be aggressive after that last play at second and 3. After the run, now to throw. Grabbed in the middle, it's Evans. And the Bulldogs get it past the sticks.
And I love when you understand when I'm supposed to put some RPMs on that football. You could tell he's thrown over the middle of the field. He knows he's got defenders there. I got to throw this thing in there quick, fast, in a hurry. Nice job by the quarterback.
Now down to the 12-yard line. It's first down. He caught it. That's about as close as you can get to that marker, and it will be second and just a few breaths away from the first down. Brings up second down. That brings us to the close of the quarter, and Ball State has the lead. They've built a cushion. They've got a nice lead. Now the task is finish the deal as you take a look at the third quarter stats. Not only is the scoreboard on their side, but so too is time as we open the fourth. Running back searching for a hole. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
So on offense, you've got to find a way to put six up on the board. You know that in this game, field goals may not get it done. So big-time players make big plays in big games. Who can you rely on right now to get you a touchdown?
Boy, they'd love to pick up this conversion and go to work with a first and goal. They'll try to get it through the air. Caught near the sticks. It's Bell. Touchdown, Dogs! They move on top here in the fourth. Number 86.
And that is phenomenal quarterbacking. Understanding right away, dude, you're going to bring pressure. I'm getting the ball to my playmaker right now. Let him do the rest. Let him glide into the end zone. Make me look really good. Good timing, good decision by the quarterback, getting it out quick.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point is good, and every point counts. It's now a 4-point lead in the fourth.
That makes the score Georgia 21, Ball State 17.
About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. Here he comes from inside his own 5. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. Ball State gets it back. The offense headed to the field. The give to the back. Gets some work done there. Pick up a 4 to the 22.
You know, it's so important for offenses to want to keep third downs manageable. The way you do that is by having success like that, running the football on first down.
After the productive first down play, it's second and 6. Looking to throw, it's Kelly. Completes it in the middle. They stop him almost immediately. Short gain there, and still a little ground to cover to pick up the first.
Nice job by the receiver on the in route there. And how about the speed? After he made his break, he was able to actually separate a little bit from the DB, helping out his QB on that one.
They'll try to move the chains on third and short from the 27. Wide receiver coming across in motion. On third and short, they'll try to pick it up on the ground here. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
How about the defender being a heat-seeking missile? He was on radar lock. He found the football and flew down with some bad intentions.
The Cardinals will bring the punt team onto the field. No return coming here as he signals for the fair catch and makes it right around the 30-yard line. And Georgia ready to go back to work on offense. And now that cushion is a little bit smaller, Jesse, and any mistake would get magnified.
Yeah, a little bit of pressure now on this offense too, David. I think they got to go back to their playmakers and get these guys going in the game.
No doubt. Find those plays you know you can run them in your sleep. You make sure you execute. Build this lead a little bit bigger. Put this thing away in the fourth quarter.
They've got it. First and 10 at the 42. Gonna run it. It's Etienne. And he was able to get away from one tackle, but plenty of help was on the way. Decent pickup on that play.
When the offense can run the football and you can feature a guy like this that will get more yards than his block that you can really depend on, hangs on to the football, like, it makes offense super easy, especially down the stretch when you want to eat that clock and you want to possess the football. Just nice to have that kind of guy.
And the Dogs get enough to move the chains.
Well, the defense didn't blitz. They didn't have everybody in gaps, and the offensive line took advantage at the point of attack, getting some push, opening up a hole, and the offense ripping off a nice run there.
It's first and 10 from the 31. Used the play fake, now to throw. And the defense gets home and makes a play at the 37-yard line.
This defense, they are tenacious, and they've got guys up front that are athletic and that are so strong and can collapse the pocket. You saw it right there in that play-action attempt.
Time is on their side, and they're going to wind that play clock all the way down. Looking to throw, it's Beck. Quickly to the tight end. Finds a crease at the 20. They're able to keep him out of the end zone. He'll be stopped at the 2 after the big play in the passing game.
As a defense, it's so hard covering this guy. Because of his frame, you're not really going to match up. But this guy's also got some wheels. The hard part is bringing him down after the catch. This guy's like a giant giraffe. You're just lions hanging on his neck trying to drag him to the ground. Not easy to do.
So this offense has the lead. They have the ball. They have the clock on their side and a chance perhaps to put it out of reach. A first down run on the doorstep. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Bulldogs!
And what a push up front by this offensive line. Everyone playing in unison, driving out of their stance, working into the second level, hats on hats, creating a lane for that running back. Well, offensively, they knew they were going to have some matchups they could take advantage of in this one. And all of a sudden, this quarterback has now over 300 yards passing in the game. Defensively, David, he has got them on their heels.
And he's been showing you a little bit of everything. He can throw it all over the field to all different receivers, to his tight ends, to his running backs. Really has the ability to spread it around. And now over 300 yards. Still some time left, and he can put up even bigger numbers. And, heck, go chase some awards, man. Get some postseason awards. Get an All-American. Just put up a day.
About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And he takes this from inside the 5. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. Ball State takes over the football, and the Cardinal offense headed out. The last time we saw this offense, we had to look quick. It was a 3-and-out, Jesse.
They just had no rhythm in that last drive. So someone's going to have to step up and make a play, David, and get this thing going.
Yeah, let's find some juice. Find your guy. Find those plays that you know you can run inside out, forward, backwards. Get some first downs. Get some positive momentum.
You open a drive like that, and the entire playbook opens up on first down from the 44. Looking to move it through the air. Steps away. This time they were able to keep him in check and stop him short of that first down.
Well, you're making a positive out of a negative. And that time, quarterback, nice job, buying time. He's trying to throw the football downfield, nothing there. So instead of throwing it away, getting the incomplete, Really, just get what you can get and make this next down more manageable.
Second down here, and maybe they've got time to get one more snap off before the two-minute warning. To the air, it's Kelly. Hauls it in. Brought to the ground, but not before getting enough for the first down. 2 minutes now left in this one, and time is running short if they want to find a way to pull this one out. Finally, some signs of life from this offense, which has done nothing in the second half. It's first and 10. Fires to the wideout. And he had it for a second, but it just dribbled out of his hands.
Well, they're trying to hit the out route to the perimeter of the field. It's a good route by the wide receiver. He just drops the ball.
They'll line up for a second down play. Couldn't connect on first down, now back to the air. And he got a hand in there, knocks it away, incomplete.
Zone coverage that time, and the cornerback, a nice job with his eyes. He's watching the quarterback, he sees the ball thrown, so he knows exactly when to break on it. He's able to break it up for an incompletion.
They were really starting to put a drive together, but after a couple of incompletions, now they need a big play on third and 10. From the gun, wants to pass. Pocket starts to collapse, and the quarterback will be slung down back at the 43.
And the defense there goes zone coverage, maybe confused the quarterback a little bit, forced him to hold on to the football, and that allowed the pass rush to get home.
Down in the fourth quarter, it's too late for empty possessions. They'll go for it on fourth down. He'll try to throw and pick up the first down. It's incomplete, and they desperately needed to keep that drive going, and they couldn't make the connection. The give as they work on that clock. And maybe he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. Quick timeout called by the defense, stopping the clock to save as much time as possible for their offense. Ordinarily on second and 10, you might look past, but here you just want to keep that clock moving. From the gun, the give, looking for room. Still on his feet at the 45. Hit the gas, kid, wide open ahead. And he'll sprint in for the score. Touchdown, Georgia.
I love the execution on that play. Great blocking up front just to get the ball carrier an opportunity in the second level of the defense. And then at that point, it was make a guy miss and use the speed. That was a perfectly executed play.
Lining up to add another.
The kicker is on for the extra point.
And now with the extra point, they're up by 18 here in the fourth. That drive took no time at all. A couple of plays and finished it with a long run for the touchdown. The kickoff team takes the field to boot this one away. He'll start the return inside his five. And the returner will be dragged down. State gets it back, the offense headed to the field. This has been a really disappointing performance, David, no question about that, but they can find some positives. And that pass intercepted. And they'll drag him down after a good return on the interception. That's why you love veterans in this defense. They stay locked in on their rules, and he made the pick. Boy, this is just the type of field position this offense wants. On the ground, it's Etienne.
And it's just simple. Simple first down run, showing your physicality, setting your offense up in a good spot.
Second down coming up.
Solid pickup of four on first down. It's second and six. He'll keep it himself. And the defense makes the stop after a minimal gain.